We are talking to Bubba Jenkins, one of the best fighters, 145, an MMA fighter, has a huge wrestling background, won the national championship out of ASU.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Got them forks up.
You just had a sensational win. Tell us about your last fight.
Yeah, man. I went out there to London on a VIP event, man. It had all dignitaries, governors, kings, princes. It was some, you know, it was some bougie type stuff. It was pretty swag, though. I was the main event against a really tough Brazilian fighter named Lucas. And I knocked him out in about 3 minutes. I went in, did my dizzy, got busy on him a little bit, and now I'm the champion, undisputed, two times over. And then I guess I spurred some things. I'm buzzing like a bee, and Ali hit me up and was like, "Yo, come sit with me." Bubba, so I'm there now.
Line up three people you'd want to fight. I don't care what sanction, I don't care what sport. It could be boxing, MMA. Who would you want? Three names.
Three names I would want to fight. Ah, man. Boxing, I would want to fight Bud Crawford because he's my favorite boxer of all time.
He's one of the best pound-for-pound fighters.
He's one of the best pound-for-pound. He's mean. He's gritty. I'm a massive fan of him. To share the cage with someone like that.
Oh, you want to bring him into MMA. You might have the advantage, right?
Ah, man. Yeah, absolutely. If I could take him down after he hit me, that would be good for me.
But in the boxing ring? That's the...
So I would take that. But in MMA, man, you know what? I would like to fight Palmer because if I'm being honest with myself, I'm seeing him make millions over there at that organization. Organization in PFL, and I'm getting hungry. You know what I'm saying? I got to feed these kids, and he got some money. And I wrestled Palmer a lot in college, and we ain't gonna speak on the outcome. He know the deal. Y'all know the facts. Y'all can see my resume. Check my dossier. But after that, I'm gonna say Connor because that's the money ticket.
Bubba underscore Jenkins and IG for everybody. But I gotta ask you this: Nate Diaz, Masvidal. Let me ask both you guys.
Yeah, Georgie's my boy. Masvidal,
he's a great dude. But I got Nate winning.
No, you don't. Stop that.
Want to bet?
Don't. I do want to bet.
Okay, let's bet push-ups. Push-ups.
Yes,
because I don't like taking money from fighters.
No, I do push-ups.
Okay,
50 on it.
50?
50 straight push-ups.
100.
Okay, 100.
We got 100 push-ups.
But it ain't straight because you can't do them straight.
No, I can't do them straight, but I'll do 100.
100 push-ups.
100 push-ups.
You said it right here. I got George Mondo.
I'm going to be in Gardena the day after the fight.
Hey, I got Jorge.
Counting them out.
I got Mr. Take Your Head Off. I got Baby Jesus. I got Masvidal. And tell him I said it. We sent him. 305. Let's get it.
I got Nate. How about this one?
Okay.
209.
Khabib.
Khabib. Yes, sir.
Against Tony Ferguson. That's what it sounds like. I mean, he can fight anyone.
Man, I'm in this new camp, and they love Khabib around
here.
So
you got Khabib.
I don't want to step on those shoes in disrespect. But no, I didn't say that. I didn't say that.
What
you know,
that?
You see me shining. You know, I got to say something when I ain't saying nothing, you know. I see you, Usman. Uh-huh. Showing up fashion. Hey, baby, I feel you. I got Ferguson. I'm sorry.
I know
I'm in the camp of Khabib and the people love him, but I got Tony F. That's my man.
That's your boy.
And he's a wrestler. He got the wrestling tat on it. So you feel me?
Yeah, you can have a question.
Let's go, TMZ.
Who do you think is going to win the Bellator 145?
I got AJ McKee. That's my dog. He's young. He's hungry. He's tough.
He's from Long Beach.
He's from Long Beach. That's my dude. We train together. I got him winning it.
Okay, cool.
I don't think anybody can deal with his size, his length, his aggression, his youth, his athleticism. He's a hungry dog.
What's the wrestler? What's his name?
Nope, don't matter. AJ McKee.
Bubba.
Yes, sir.
How do you get the name Bubba? Is that from Forrest Gump from the movie?
No, I was 11 pound baby, dog. I was huge. I was
11 massive. Pounds?
Yeah, everybody thought I was going to be 6'4", 290 or something, but I'm not. But I was just a big baby, and it just stuck with me. I was huge. Like, I was 11 pounds.
Cody, you know Bubba Jenkins?
Bubba Sparks, you talking about?
You already know me and back to singlets that flip red and blue. Back to the strike.
You know who
Back to the strike group singlets.
How about, what's up, Fabrizio?
Hey, man, how are you?
Hey, I've known him for years. Great dude, man. Great fighter.
In the building.
Right.
Okay. How about him and Adrian Broner in a boxing ring?
Man, the head movement is good. Adrian Broner. Man, Adrian's been falling off lately.
He's still a four division champion.
And man, I got no love.
That's a good scrap.
Love.
I say, hey, Ohio boys going after it.
Oh man, hey, I like that Cincinnati.
Yeah, okay, now you'll be surprised who he called out.
Who Bubba called out?
Terence Crawford.
All right,
you gotta love Bud though.
Hey, Bud.
You gotta love
Bud. We got love for Bud.
You gotta love. Yeah. You need the pound for pound greatness.
Plus, he got his little sons and little beast wrestlers.
And they're wrestlers.
Wrestlers, boxers.
I love everything about Bud Crawford.
That's the most dangerous combination you have: a wrestler and a boxer. And
Bud Crawford. He's gonna teach him wrong. He's gonna teach him
orthodox. He's gonna teach him southpaw.
Man, they're gonna be wrong when they come
out. Yeah, they're gonna be good.
Love the shedded boxing ring.
I'm excited to watch them. Yeah, Bud's a good guy. That's
to learn dead on with the sweet science of that man.
Honestly, like for me, my uncle taught me it. and it helped out with my wrestling so much. You know what I mean? Like this angles, weight distribution.
Yeah.
Like never, you know, and it was just went hand in hand. So I would stay sharp from my wrestling angles because they were the same angles as my boxing angles.
The same angles.
So I would get out of wrestling season and my uncle would have me go spar all these guys, you know, in sparring camps that are deep, you know, getting ready to fight like Porter and Paul Spadafora and all these other guys that are up there coming out. I would, you know, get the rust off a couple rounds, hit the pads, and you know, feel good, and I would be right on. So it kept my angles.
You sparred Sean Porter?
Oh, we used to always, man.
Dude, he was huge in amateurs.
Oh, he was in beast, man. He used to.
No, I'm saying physically, he was big too.
Oh yeah, yeah.
How do you do when you spar Sean Porter?
Oh, he was good, man. He was, you know, we went at a good pace. He's, you know, he's so talented, and, you know.
And now he's doing huge in the boxing ring.
He's huge, man. He's huge. His father, Kenny, man, is great. I love the work ethic, the way that they have that dynamic together. You know, Kenny gets on him, and a lot of people would crack under that kind of pressure. But their father and son dynamic, he can coach him to a point to where a lot of people would break down and shut off and be done. But he goes,
and
hey, he goes, I know
how
it is.
You see that their dynamic is not one that is fabricated. That father-son relationship is real, and therefore the results is real.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He, that's the gritty way that he liked to get it. And his dad is like, okay, if you like to be gritty, like a football player, kind of wrestler, kind of, then fuck, I'm going to coach you that way.
Now, Bubba's missing two things today, a nice mink coat and a cane. Cause look at the hat, look at the shoes.
Man, you see me?
Bubba Sparks, man.
You see me? You see me?
You see Xbox.
Everybody, make sure to follow Cody No Love.
Appreciate it.
And No Love Bullies, if you want a bully. Very unique dogs. Do you have dogs yet?
I'm getting one. We're talking about
yes?
it.
Yes, he's gonna get.
He used to do pits back in the day when we were like in the 2000s. He was at Penn State, and that's what we always talked about. Now we're doing bullies. You know, it's great.
Great dog, great temperament.
Yeah, great to hunt. The best temperament.
By the way, you have a dog named Canelo.
Canelo.
What do you think Canelo would say? I'm gonna see him soon. I'm gonna say, did you know Cody's dog?
I would hope he would be honored. You know what I mean? Like, I was honored. You know, Canelo's one of the greatest dogs. I take him everywhere. He's a service dog. Everybody loves him, and you know, Canelo's my favorite boxer, so I was like, man, you know, that's my boy Canelo.
Last thing I gotta ask you, Khabib against Tony Ferguson, if it happens.
You know what, I gotta go with Khabib. You know, nothing wrong with Tony. I think his style is a little different. Shows some different things, the approach, but Khabib's dominance and his grappling, to be able to shut that stuff down, the scrambles, the funky rules, the inverted stuff, the Del Hiva, all that style that... that Tony does. I think Khabib's too strong and skilled in that area to where he can shut all that shit down and just ride him out.
All right, there you have it. Thank you so much. Stay tuned.